So you talk about that recorder. So do we hear that clear noise, or it's only hear over the frequency?
No, actually we hear proper voices.
Cat screaming. That's something Bohan that you are looking for.
As I was asking question, I happened to ask how many spirits are here, and instantly Pooja says 6. So Pooja just hears the word 6.
How many of you are here?
6.
So to call them, and I strongly recommend that no one should do this, but you know, to call a spirit, you just have to stand and call out that if there is anyone, just talk to me. And they'll just listen, they will listen to you. Where, you know, this particular room was closed for more than 30-40 years, and we happened to open it because it is said that, it was said that there is a particular spirit that is haunting that place, and they have locked it.
Hello guys, welcome to The Haunted Show. I am your host Darshan. Today we have our guest Sarbajit Mohanty. Thank you, sir, for coming here.
Thank you so much for inviting me. Thank you so much.
So, as you told ki, you have to dominate that haunted place. So, share some experience.
Yeah, there's this one particular one that I'm getting right now is, again, this one is again in Odisha. So, we are investigating this riverbed in a place called Kendrapada. And this place has been, very prone to cyclones and all, and there's this super cyclone that happened in 1998 or 1999, where a lot of people died. So we were called by this entire village to investigate this patch of road that used to connect two villages basically, and that road was adjacent to a river, the entire village just called, and they were like, you know, they are seeing headless creatures who are walking on the road, headless creatures walking on their four legs on the riverbed, and that every time someone is traveling on or, you know, commuting through that road, they are getting attacked by these creatures, and they want a solution because they are not able to do anything because of that, you know, breakage of the road. And we went there, and we, as a part of our investigation, we have to interview people to know what they're going through, the history of the place, and you know, what they think could be happening. And as we are talking, this old lady just walks to me, and she just says, you know, like, beta, ye to ye koi mamuli jagah nahi hai, ye to shaitan ka ghar hai. And I'm like, this is not the first time I've heard something like that. But then deep inside, something was like, you know, okay, this case is going to be interesting. And the very same day, I get a message from Pooja as I'm traveling to the location that, Sarba, I am having this feeling that you should be aware of something negative. Now, what negative, she explains, but I'll say what she warned me about. Now, we go to the place. The villagers take us to this riverbed, and they were like, sir, this is the place, I'm not going to join you because I'm very scared, I'm leaving. So we're like, yeah, you leave. So it's me and three of my crew guys, two camera guys, one sound guy, and myself. We start our investigation. So the road is kind of on a flat land, but if you have to go to the riverbed, you have to go down. And so we go down with the camera equipment and the devices, and we start our investigation. During the investigation, 15-20 minutes it has passed, and we were like, you know, okay, this place is good, you know, because there were no replies coming. So we thought okay, maybe we will just wrap up as soon as possible and we'll go back home. And this place is like around 400 kilometers away from Bhubaneswar. So I said, yeah, it's good that we are hardly getting any, you know, replies. Maybe there is nothing here, and it's just the villagers who are scared, and we'll wrap up soon. So 15 minutes to it, it starts raining, and we are like, arey yaar, abhi break ho gaya flow. So we are like, fine, let's go back to the car. And we go back to the car, and we take shelter for 5-10 minutes, and after 5-10 minutes the rains have cleared, and we go back again. And this time when we go back after a break of 5-10 minutes, the vibes have changed. This time it feels very weird, and I'm like, what happened? Like, abhi 5-10 minute mein kya ho gaya? Like, why does it feel so weird right now here? Even with the vibes and the frequencies and the energies around, it feels very different, very dark and very dense. And I'm like, this is weird. And then aise check karte karte meri nazar gayi upar, and I saw that it is full moon. that very night. So I'm like, yeah, I think this is what is triggering something. So now that we start our communication, now replies are coming, which were not coming 15-20 minutes back. I'm like, yeah, that's fine, because if you are getting a reply, it's good. From a show point of view, अच्छा है, content मिलेगा. And so we asked one of the cinematographers, before that what happens is, it was a huge place, it was like football field जैसा था, and we like, let's do one thing, we are four people, let's split into two. You two go that side, I'll take one camera guy and we'll go to the other side. And me and the camera guy, we are at one point, and the other two people, one camera and the sound guy, they're on the other point of the field, of the riverbed. And 5 minutes to that, the guy who was on that side, he starts shouting, Sarbajit, Sarbajit. I'm like, what happened? And he starts running towards me. For a moment, I thought there's a crocodile in the river, because there are reports of crocodiles in the river. So I start running towards him. I'm like, you know, are you fine? Is it all okay? And he says, I saw someone standing behind you.
Okay.
I'm like, what did you see? He just says that I see this old lady kind of, you know, in all white, just standing and staring at you. I'm like, where did you see? So he points, you know, okay, beach mein udhar. And I'm like, there is no way it could have happened, because I would have seen it because it is right in my peripheral, and I would have seen if there was anyone manifesting. He said, no, I'm very sure. I'm like, please come and show me, pinpoint what is the point. Now, as he's walking with me, he says, Sarbajit, I can't see that spot. It is very blurry to me. I can see other areas. I'm like, this is something weird. How is it possible that you are only seeing, you can't see this place, and it is suddenly blurry for you while you can see other areas? He said, I don't know. So I said, maybe you're just scared right now. You're panicking. Let's take a break. You can let me know where all this happened so that I can recreate a scenario. And I'll see if the spirit is coming back. So I send them back, and I again stand the way I was standing. I made the cameraman stand the way he was standing, and we recreated the entire thing, and nothing happened. I said, okay, you know, maybe just, you know, it's just as a fear because of what is happening. I ignored it. So then we asked one of the camera guys to, you know, record some B-roll and all for the shot, for the episode. And we are standing at one point, and the cameraman goes, say, you know, like 50 meter away to take shot. So 10 minutes to his cinematography, he starts, you know, running towards us, shouting mummy, mummy, and everything. And he's a 30-35 years old guy. And we were like, what happened now? He's like, someone tapped on my shoulder. And I'm like, that's impossible. Why? Because there could be trees above you, and the branches could be hitting, because it is windy right now after the rains. He said, okay, aray, there is not a single tree where I was shooting. How can it happen? Manika, show me. And he takes me, and there's not a single tree. I'm like, okay, so things are coming alive right now. And as we are trying to communicate, the communication is happening. Chote chote replies are, sab kuch ho raha hai. As that is happening, one of the guy who actually saw the apparition, he finds some kind of a thing, of a cloth that is wrapped under one of the trees. And the tree was like, had no leaves. I don't remember it well. It was in 2016. But it was like, you know, it had branches and all, but it was a huge tree. And under the tree, he finds this particular wrap that is out there. And he says, Sarbajit, I think this is blood. And so, you know, he's like away from it 10-15 meters. And I just shout, don't touch it directly. Just use a stick to find out if you want to see what is in there. Now, as I am saying this, I'm walking towards him. At one point, what happened? I don't know what happened. So I keep one step in that radius where they found the cloth. And all those fears I had as a teenager, as a kid, as all my childhood stories, all my childhood fears, they just came gushing in my mind. For a moment, I started fearing again. I'm like, what the hell is happening now? Why is it happening to me right now? Like, I have worked so hard to reach the state of not fearing. Why am I fearing right now? I was so scared to take another step, because I don't know what I'm going to encounter. I started getting scared of the paranormal. It hit me so hard that, you know, what is happening to me? So I sat down. I literally sat down out there. And I was like, this is wrong. What is happening is wrong. And I know it is the spirit that is manipulating my emotions, as I was talking about. They can bring out the worst fears of yours, you know, into your mind. And it is the spirit that is manipulating me. So 5-10 minutes, I just sit down. I'm like, I'm not doing anything now. The crew has started panicking because they were all dependent on me. So they're like, if Sarbajit can be affected like this, what will happen to us? I'm like, I don't care right now. I need 5-10 minutes to settle down. So 5-10 minutes on that, you know, wet grasses, I just sat down. I just grounded myself and I'm like, you know, okay, no, this is wrong. I have to overpower it right now. So I just stand up and just, and that particular area, I just charge in shouting. I'm like, whatever the hell of a spirit you have no right to affect me like this. Just know I'm more powerful than you and any of your trick is going to fail. I just start shouting and abusing and everything, all so that I could dominate that entire place. And I go in, you know, I enter that area where they found this thing. And as they are opening up the cloth, which was actually kind of blood, we think, there was this voodoo doll inside that, that is used for black magic. And in that was this symbol kind of a thing that was drawn in them. And when I saw that doll and when I saw that sign, then I realized the warning Pooja gave me. Pooja said that Sarba, be, you know, be warned of something that is going to happen. And she later says that during that phone call in the morning, that you are going to encounter something related to witchcraft. I'm like, witchcraft? I'm not going to investigate a witchcraft thing. But then when we find this voodoo doll thing, voodoo doll and the symbol were all connected to witchcraft. And we were like, you know, I don't know what to do now. You know, I don't know what to do next. So the crew was like, I think we have enough content. We should wrap up. I said, yeah, fine, not a problem. Because even I'm drained right now, let's wrap up. And as we are doing this, and I still cannot believe what I saw, you know, and it, coming from me, it is still very bizarre. Why? Because I'm a guy who is completely dependent on everything scientific. If something is not explained or cannot be debunked, I'm like, this cannot happen. I'm open to the possibilities of paranormal, but what I saw that day kind of challenged very hardly, because as we are wrapping up, so we have to climb up to get to the car. Ek patthar girta hai. And I'm like, you know, someone threw it. So I asked the crew, did you see that? The crew was like, yeah. And then in 2-3 seconds, another stone falls. Stones as in pebbles. Then in 2-3 seconds, another pebble falls. Now there are random pebbles falling at every plate, that every area. Now generally when a pebble is thrown, it will have a projectile motion. You know, it will come parallel to the ground and then fall on you. These pebbles were falling like they are falling straight from the sky.
Yeah.
Like it was raining pebbles. Yeah. I was like shocked, how can this happen? How can it rain pebbles right now? Mm. The place was so intense.
Mm.
But we got up anyway and we were in the car and we are talking. Did we just experience this phenomena where pebbles are falling from the sky?
Mm.
And we all were shocked. Mm. And whatever it was, we went back home and all the crew members, excluding me, they all had their, you know, some of the bizarre nightmares they ever had, which were discussed the next day. Because we had these nightmares. So I said, probably it's the after effect of the place that we went to. But it was a crazy, insane place, and it's one of the investigations that is not yet closed. It is still open.
Oh. So you not resolved that?
Not yet. It's been 6 years.
So that place is still haunted?
Still very much haunted. Well, I think so.
So tell me more about witchcraft and...
Well, it's a very vast world of witchcraft actually. I'm sorry, I'm not the right guy to talk about it because I have very less knowledge. I just know that witchcraft has got this very wrong tag here in India. Witchcraft is not always about evil things. So witches basically, which is very, very different from what we call as... What would you call witches in Hindi? What is it called?
Dayan
or Chudel.
Chudel, yeah.
Yeah, so Chudel and Dayan are very, very different from what actually witches are.
Yeah.
So witches are actually people who play with the five elements of earth to create magic or to heal people basically.
Yeah.
But that particular using of elements can either be used to heal someone or it can either be used to harm someone. So someone who harms others is a bad witch, and someone who harms does good is a good witch or is a healer. I call Pooja a witch only. Everyone calls Pooja a witch because of her psychic abilities and, you know, the healing that she does and everything. So that's what it is. But in India, we have this notion that witches will be having this long nose, you know, sitting on a broom with green skin and with a cauldron of whatever liquid in there. It's a wrong thing. It's cartoonish, very honestly. But yeah, this is what I know about witchcraft. And I know that it's very much, you know, we often cross paths with this witchcrafty thing somewhere, well, in some cases or the other.
Have you seen any witch?
Yeah, like I said, Pooja is a witch. So I've seen her. I've seen her, you know, I see her every day. So I also know other people who are doing equivalent job like Pooja. And they all are witches like that. And because they are, you know, the things they do, the way they help people is magical. And anyone who can perform magic is a witch only.
Yeah. Can you share with us your most memorable investigation?
Yeah, sure. There are a lot of them actually, but one of them that I'm getting right now is this case that we investigated. I think it's one of my favorite as of now because of the evidences we captured wahan pe. We were called by this old lady who was accompanied only by her grandchildren, and her son and daughter-in-law, two son and two daughter-in-law passed away in a car accident. And there were things happening in the, so they were staying in the ground floor, and there were things happening on the upper floor. And they were like, sir, bahut kuch ho raha hai, and my kids are getting affected, my grandchildren are getting affected, and it would be great if you could just come down and investigate. I'm like, yeah, that's fine, not a problem. And you know, we go down with the team, and we are checking this place. So this is like an abandoned room. It has like two bedrooms, one hall, a kitchen and a bathroom. That's it. And so as we are, you know, planning to investigate, Pooja was again unfortunately not with us, and she being the psychic, it's important that every case has to go through her or the psychics. That's how the investigation begins. So because she was not there, I just clicked photographs and I sent it to her. And I asked Pooja, you know, if you could just give me a reading. Right now I'm doing a preliminary, you know, Reiki kind of the place, and it would be great if I get a reading. And Pooja takes 5-10 minutes, and then she, you know, calls back and says, "Ke Sarba, I am sensing that there is a female who was choked, and she was dragged across this house, this room, and she was killed and she was dumped right next to the building." And this is all of these things you got as psychic reading. And she was like, yes. And I'm like, but there is no, and she says, okay, and where she is dumped, there is a tree now, or like, you know, she was dumped right under the tree. And I'm like, but the family never mentioned me about any tree or anything as such. So I just happened to ask one of the crew members to check, you know, with the family if there is any tree or anything as such. And the family says, ke sir, wo tree se hi to sare activities shuru hoti hain. And I'm like, what do you mean? So they see this female entity, female spirit, that comes, you know, behind the tree, walks the road that is right in front of their house, enters their house, goes to the top floor, to the terrace, and jumps off the building. All of them see her. The neighbors see her, and when they would go to see if there's any dead body, they would find nothing. Then once upon a time, one of the grandchildren, he goes to the abandoned area to record something, and he heard some weird noise coming from the flat. And as he's coming out, you know, in a very scared way to, you know, come back to his home, basically, he says that he was pushed by some unseen dark entity. Pushed so hard that he breaks his iPad and also injures himself. So these are the things that have happened to him. Now Pooja gives this reading, okay, this is what happened. So I am like, okay, this is going to be interesting, because the spirit sounds very raging, as in very aggressive, very angry. So maybe we will see what are the replies we are getting from her. So the sun sets and we start our investigation. And as the investigation begins, the first thing we start hearing is footsteps coming from the terrace. And I thought it's one of my crew member that is up there. So I happened to send one of the crew guys, and we communicate through walkie-talkies. And I said, you know, if you could just check if there is someone walking, because it is disturbing me right here. And the guy is standing up there looking at the terrace, and he says, sir, there is no one here because I am right in front of it, the terrace, and even I can hear the footsteps. So there is no one in front of him, but he's hearing footsteps out there. And I'm like, okay, so this is the beginning of the communication. So I just say, you know, what are you doing up on the terrace? You have to come down. This is where I'm waiting for you, right? You can't be up there. And you have to come down here. And we are not getting any replies on our devices. And it's only the, you know, footsteps that are continuously happening up there. And then I am like, you know, and it's been 30 minutes, nothing is happening, and I'm starting to lose my patience, and I'm like, you know, let's do one thing. So as we are doing Reiki, we found out this one room where we find this teddy bear on the floor. It's a doll that is on the floor, and I happen to call it the Annabelle of India for all the right reasons. So we find this doll, and I'm like, you know, is this doll yours? And suddenly, as I ask this question, the footsteps stops suddenly, and I'm like, if this doll is yours, I'm going to take it home with me. You know, if you're not coming down, I'm going to take it home with me. Do whatever you want to do. As I'm doing this, I'm holding the device, I'm holding the doll, and the device blinks after 45 minutes of me trying to communicate. And I'm like, you know, so finally you are here, so let's communicate. But that was not why it was here. The spirit actually started affecting my crew. Why? The sound guy, he starts coughing, you know, and I'm like, it's probably because of the dust and all. But 15 minutes later, he coughs so hard that he's on the ground right now, and he says, the service I'm having this choky feeling. Exactly what Pooja shared as a reading, that she even felt that choky feeling. And now I know that the spirit is trying to harm them somewhere or the other, you know. And I'm like, you know, now this cannot happen. They didn't do anything. They are just doing their job. I'm the one that is trying to provoke you, right? So you have to do something. Do it with me. I'm standing right here. So as a way to provoke it more, to you know, to or gussa dilane ke liye, the doll that I was holding, I threw it as a sign of disrespecting her, you know. Yeah. So you want to get someone, get me, you know. That was my way of telling her. So I throw the doll to a particular corner, and I'm like, you know, whatever you want to do, you do. And then as we are going to different rooms, the entire home, entire house was like, you know, kind of like becoming a tornado of activities in there. Things were happening here, there, awaazein aa rahi hain, wo ho raha hai, EMF devices getting spiked up, things are happening, that are happening. Now, there are 2-3 major things that happened at that particular place. When we were doing the Reiki, we saw at one particular shelf, there was this huge rock that are, you know, used for constructing.
Yeah.
So probably a part of the building or part of the flat was broken, and they have kept it up there safely so that no one hits their leg because they have got children. And I marked it because I knew, okay, there is something up there. So as we are trying to, you know, recollect what is happening and all, I asked the camera guy that, you know, you just go and take some shot. Again, the same camera guy who got tapped. And he is allegedly standing in front of the kitchen, and he is taking some shots. It's pitch dark. And again, he starts shouting. And this time he's just shouting my name. Sarbajit, Sarbajit. I'm like, what happened? And we were like in the adjacent room, and we come down to kind of rescue him, and we see, and you know, I see that his legs are kind of like bent, like someone is pulling it, and he's saying, Sarbajit, someone is pulling my leg. I'm like, faltu giri mat kar. That was my first reaction, you know. He's like, no, I'm not faking it. You can also, and I'm seeing that his legs are, you know, in a way that someone is. Like it is being pulled, but he's like, you know, okay, I'm really serious that someone is pulling my leg. Now, so we kind of pull him out, there's three of us, and I'm like, you know, there is no chance this could be happening. There is a high chance that there is a wire or there is something where you got your leg stuck, and that was happening, nothing else. I go down, I enter the kitchen, and there are no strings, there are no wires, there is nothing. And I'm like, you know, if there is actually something that is manifesting so strongly, so aggressively, there must be some imprint of whatever happened on your body. So we were, I asked, you know, ke kahan pe pakda tha? So he showed me ankle ke paas, and we asked him to lift his pant, and we see there are 5 complete fingerprints on his leg, like dark burning marks kind of a thing on his legs. And I'm like, okay, so now it is reacting, it is replying to us. Now as that is happening, we hear this loud thud, and I'm like, what is that noise? And it felt like it came from like as a 5 meter bhi nahi usse kam distance se awaaz aayi. So it's pitch dark, right? So as we are turning our torches on to see what happened, that 40-50 kilos rock that was up there is now on the ground being pushed by something unseen, and is right next to us falling on the ground. And I'm like, you know, you have to chill right now because you are getting very aggressive. This is not what I asked for. I'm only here to help you out. So that is where my dominating character comes out and start, yeah, you know, so that, because I have to protect the crew, I have to protect the things that are happening in there. And right now the crew is like, you know, that I think we should stop recording. We are getting affected. And one of the crew guys says ke, you know, his hands were shaking holding the camera. And we are like, they were like, Sarbajit, let's just, you know, go home, we are done. I'm like, no, we cannot go home right now because it has just started showing itself to us. How can we just dump everything? I was saying from a very researcher point of view, of course it was selfish, but I knew I would protect them. So yeah, that was my confidence. And I said, let's do one thing. Let's go to this point and just sit there and let's do nothing. Let's not get into anything. Let's not communicate. Just sit.
Yeah.
Let's see what happens. Mm. So that aapno ka dar kam ho jaye by then. And then, जैसे ही शुरुआत हुई थी, the way it all began with the tornado-ish feeling and all, it all started receding. And you know, I just happened to ask before all this started, you know, decreasing the activity, I just happened to ask this one sentence: are you aware that you are dead? Are you aware that you do not belong to this place? This place is not yours anymore. You should cross over. And right after that question, the activity started decreasing. And after that, we sat down for 45 minutes to 1 hour at that place, and we got no single reply, no things, nothing is happening. Of course, there's a lot of other elements to it, small elements, which I'm skipping. But we are trying to wrap it up and everything. So as we're trying to wrap it up, if you remember, I mentioned you that I threw that doll to one particular corner of the room, and I saw it happening because the camera panned, there was a shot of it.
Yeah.
As we are wrapping up, we are like, you know, okay, kuch device to nahi choda, and we are going to every room to find out if we have left anything. And we enter the room where we found the doll initially, and guess what? The doll is back to its original position from where we had picked it up.
Okay.
It is not there in the corner anymore. It is back to exactly where it was. It was the reason, the doll was the reason why all these things happened, why all these activities happened, and that's why I call it the animal of India.
Yeah.
But one thing I realized that day is, no matter how angry a spirit is, how rageful a spirit is, how evil a spirit is, sometimes they are just not aware that they are dead. This angry spirit became angry because it was stuck for so many years and trying to communicate with someone, trying to get attention of someone, is kind of what, you know, I think made her so angry, you know, because the tenants who used to live in this abandoned house have complained of, you know, food plates being snatched away by unseen forces.
Yeah.
But because of so many years of being ignored and not getting help, probably made her so rageful. And just my one question that you do not belong to this place and that you are dead, you should cross over, just helped her in moving on from that place. That was a solution of that haunting. A month later, after we wrapped up the investigation, we get a call from the old lady again, and she says ke beta abhi yahan pe kuch bhi nahi hota ek mahine se. Everything is fine the day you got the investigation done, and that this month only there are new tenants coming in and are going to stay up there.
Yeah.
So, you know, this was one of my favorite moments because of the things we are capturing. The fingerprints, I still have the photo of it. It's one of the memorable things. And after the investigation, we went out to have some coffee because of the intense thing that we went through. And I just happened to ask the camera guy, you know, can you just show me your leg again if it is still there? And we lift his pant and there's nothing. The fingerprints are gone the way they came. No one knows how they came, no one knows how they went out. But his leg was normal like it was before.
So thank you so much, Sarbajit, for coming here and sharing your experience with us. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. And if you like this video, please like, share, comment and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.